Hello, my dear professionals. Welcome back to Corporate Diaries. So today we'll be discussing a very important topic and pretty interesting as well. It's all about video resumes. Companies have started asking for video resumes. So if you haven't made one for yourself, I'll suggest you to invest some time in creating a video resume for yourself, because it's an amazing opportunity to grab the attention of employer among all who have not yet given it a thought to create a video resume. In this video, I'll be educating you on how to create video resumes, of course, and what to avoid in video resumes. Also, we'll be discussing upon a very interesting angle where there's a specific situation where you must avoid video resume, because in that situation, it will harm you more than doing good for you. So if you're interested in knowing how to create video resumes, what are the do's and don'ts, and what is that one angle, one situation where you must avoid creating a video resume, then keep on watching. So let's start by discussing what is a video resume and how it can benefit you. A video resume is, of course, where you would interact directly through the video with the employer, detailing on what you can bring to the table and why they should hire you. But please remember, it is not at all the video format of the text resume that we all create. You cannot just read your text resume in your video that you're creating for a video resume. So let's understand what are the parameters that you should consider while creating a video resume. And the number one is the length of your resume. The length of your resume should be ideally between 1 minute to 2 minutes. It shouldn't be more than 2 minutes. People who are, of course, on higher roles, like CEO and executive roles, they of course can have little lengthier video resumes. But as a fresher or early professional, 2 minutes are more than sufficient. If you have a video of length more than that, it simply indicates that you have exaggerated something or you are just stretching the points unnecessarily. So try to trim it to just 1 minute to 2 minutes max. And next is a very important parameter, your comfort level in front of the camera. For any individual who is not doing videos, creating videos in their day to day, the way they interact with the camera is very different. If you specifically want to see what I mean, then I recommend you to go back and visit some of my older videos when I started this channel. You will clearly find the difference between how odd it looked then to my comfort level towards interacting with the camera. You might not be able to feel it, but the person who's looking at that video can sense it very clearly. And it is very natural that you will have that oddness when you start shooting your videos. So the point is, do not pressurize yourself to create your video resume just in one day. Do the rehearsals, take sessions for several days, and when you finally feel that you have that comfort level of interacting with the camera where you look natural and you feel this is how you speak to any other human being as well, like you're talking to the camera, the interaction level kind of looks the same, then you go ahead and shoot your video resume. Until then, wait and just do the practice or rehearse it. Because the whole point of video resume is to stand out among the rest. And if you cannot communicate confidently in that video, or I should say, you are not coming across as a confident person in that video. You might be confident about your skills otherwise when you talk in person to people. But if there's that oddness with the camera, which is pretty natural for anyone who's new to the camera, then there will be no use. You are just wasting your chance of getting shortlisted. So give it some time, and when you have that comfort level with the camera, then you can go ahead and shoot your video resume. Number three, the dimensions of your video. Prefer a horizontal video like you're watching this one, unlike the vertical videos which you see on Insta and TikTok kind of videos. The vertical where you have the format vertical, those do not look very professional and create a very informal impression. So you do not want to lose a chance just because the formatting of the video. So make sure that you shoot it in horizontal view. That will give it a more professional look. And the next point before we jump to the actual content of the video resume, what you should record in there, the last point that I want to mention is your presentability in the video. When you look in the mirror, it's very different to when you see yourself in the camera. Camera has very weird captures, I would say. That's what my experience is in recording YouTube. Before you start recording, you actually see yourself that you are not looking straight out of the bed. You're looking neat, professional, and presentable, I would say. And try to wear clothes that are covered up, because in your videos there's only little part of your body which is visible. So try not to wear off shoulders or sleeveless or something of that sort. Try to wear some covered up clothing so that whatever is visible is more professional and presentable. So now let's discuss what you should actually record in a video resume. See, video resume, unlike your text resume, is not a bullet point list of your skills. It's more of communicating your personality through that video. Obviously, you will add text along with your face in the side. Main point is that you have to bring out your personality in the video so that you can stand out. The intro of the video, 5 to 6 minutes of the video, should be captivating enough for the recruiter or the hiring manager for them to look beyond those 5 to 6 seconds, the entire 2 minute video, because that will eventually decide whether you're shortlisted or not. So in that first few minutes, you have to highlight your core skill. Say for example, "Hi, I'm Varsha KR, a HR professional with over a decade of experience in IT industry, and I specialize into..." Did you notice in just few seconds I told about my name, how many years of experience I have, what kind of industry I have worked in, and then I was moving towards more specializations. So that's exactly what you have to point out. Now let's talk about the second very important piece of content in your video resume, which will start after this 5 to 6 seconds of intro, which is you will exactly map your skills with the JD which is given. If the JD says we need a person who has the skill A, then you'll talk about, "I have acquired skill A and I have worked upon so many projects on skill A." Then if the JD says we require somebody who takes initiative and is very good at adapting, quick learning, then we'll give example of something that showcases that we have taken initiative and we have been very quick in adapting. You have to show them how exactly your skill set maps to the JD that they have posted online, and how well the mapping is, how well you fit into that role that they are looking for. If you can describe your skill set as per each bullet point, as per each requirement that company has described, nothing like it. I know the next question that must be popping in your mind, that it means that we have to create multiple video resumes. I will say that right now, not many companies are asking for video resumes. The companies who are asking, take benefit of it. Create one for every job posting that you're applying for. There would be hardly 1 in 100 which is asking for it. And if you can take advantage of this opportunity, you can highlight yourself for that position while creating the video resume, nothing like it. And then comes the closure part. Here you have to just mention 1 or 2 lines, something like, "If this resonates with you, I'm just a call away. You can contact me at," and you can list down your contact references, numbers, whatever detail, email ID you want to give. And in that way, you'll create a very beautiful video resume for yourself. Okay, so now let's discuss that situation where you must avoid creating a video resume. A situation where you are not feeling confident enough of doing a video resume, or whenever you do a video resume, you think you are not coming across as a very confident person. Now, I'm not saying that you should not apply to those companies who are asking for video resumes. I'll give you an alternate for that. But what I'm essentially saying, that instead of you directly interacting and talking about your skill set on the video, there are other ways of creating video resumes as well, where you do not have to talk. I'll talk about that. I'll give you the roadmap to that, how to create those kind of video resumes where you are not talking and still it's a video resume and you can upload for those companies' positions which are mandatorily asking for video resume and you are not comfortable creating one. Because don't forget, the main point of video resume is to enhance your chance of getting shortlisted. If you have good skills, but that oddness with the camera or that confidence in a video is kind of killing your overall chance, then what's the point? What's the point of creating a video resume? We are not here to kill our chance. We are here to enhance your chance of getting shortlisted. So for that, what you have to do is you have to use your 2-3 pictures and create a presentation. As if you do a slideshow, create a presentation, and then towards the end, when the presentation is done, save that presentation as a MP4, as a video, and that will be your video format resume without you being interacting. So guys, those were my inputs for creating a video resume, and I will highly suggest you guys to create one for yourself because it's still in the beginning stage, and if you can set yourself apart by applying with a video resume, nothing like it, you will get shortlisted very quickly.